hear me well, or use my phone? You can hear me well?
Yeah.
Okay, I prefer my natural voice. I have a high voice, so I don't need a microphone. So good morning, I'm Cristóbal Romero from the University of Cordoba. I am a member of the special group of CADIS, it's Knowledge Discovery and Intelligent Systems, a cell group. We work in data mining in general, and I am the person in my group that worked years ago from only educational data mining. The title of this keynote is Educational Data Science. I have changed the title because I prefer this new term. New term because in my other presentation I always speak about educational data mining. But now I want to speak about educational data science because it's a new term, a fashion term that I like more because it integrates not only the original term educational data mining but also the new term learning analytics. To join these two terms and also other possible new terms, because I think that we will see later this is an evolution of the term. Okay, with Crystal. This is the line. This is a very big presentation, but if we have time, we will see all, but the last few slides is more about applications, also what links, so we will see more slowly or not, depending on the time. Okay, let's start with intuition. What do we call this term? Where we come from? There are a lot of terms related, and in general, we have all these, and they are not about education, they are general terms. Statistics is one of the regions, machine learning, data mining, knowledge discovery in data, business analytics, data science, data analytics, and much more of it. So, all these terms have the same core idea. They are very, very related in the fact that they say the same idea, to find useful patterns in data. So, they are different, there are some difference between them, but they share this. They only differ in emphasis. The emphasis of the user, of the final letter, of the viewpoint we use. This is a sentence that I like a lot, that this is in good, not with trash, or the other must bring data. So, this is the idea. We need data to believe something. And this is the core that shaped all these fields. We can also see evolution in the history about this term, in order to see that it's all an evolutionary term. For example, we use Google and Graham Geber. For example, we can see that the statistics is the oldest term in time. That's the origin of statistics. In fact, when we will do educational data mining or analytics, one of the first things that we have to do to apply statistics in order to see that simple statistic probably information. If, for example, if all a student in a class pass all, why are you trying to find a student? No, all pass, so simple statistic you can see, so you don't have to do nothing. So the statistic, the basic in the order, and also analytics. Analytics, you can see in the time, is one of the order. Later, you can see new, one of the fashion in this year, in 2002, data mining is the fashion term, and later they in start to decrease. Other term related is knowledge discovery, for example, knowledge discovery that start with the conference KDD, okay, with the start, and this is only from until 2008. Okay, if we pass from 2008 to 2012, the change seems, we see the evolution of the other term, and this is data mining, the blue line is data mining, you see, it's decreasing. We also appear new terms, big data is now the fashion trend, big data. All the people are speaking now about big data, MOOC, and data science. Okay. So we can see that the question about data mining increased. Big data surge from 2012, big data increased and we can also do more update. I haven't done the more update histogram of this, but we will see that data science is now increasing. In fact, there are a lot of data science master thesis, data science. There are a lot of people speaking now in the USA, for example, about data science. No? Okay, let's see if they are really different between these terms or no. We see that they are not so much different. They are different, but they are not so much. For example, the statistic, design, collecting, describing, and interpreting data. This definition will be very related with the other. We will see later. They have area of statistics and technique. Of course, they are of this area, descriptive and statistic and inferential statistics. Machine learning. Machine learning is programming computer to optimize performance criteria using a sample of data or past experience. So past data, so also use data. About the techniques, we have techniques, supervised and unsupervised algorithms. Okay? We will see some of these techniques in the workshop about using Weka with Moodle data. So we will use Weka. Weka is a software about machine learning and data mining, so we will use this type of techniques. Weka also have some LASI statistics. We will see also LASI testing Weka. Alpha Weka is mainly oriented to data mining and machine learning. Okay, data mining and knowledge discovery is almost the same. It's almost the same. It's the non-trivial definition, non-trivial process of identifying valid, novel, potentially useful, and ultimate the standard pattern in data. We can see here that TDD is an integration of the statistic, is the new term integrated past term. So TDD is the statistic, databases, machine learning, and visualization. So it has the other previous definition included. And this is, I like to also mean this, because this is the traditional process of data mining, or the traditional process of knowledge discovery in data mining. That is, you have the data, the raw data, in the database, raw data, we select in green, we have the target data, you transfer the data to prepare or process the data, to apply data mining pattern in order to obtain pattern and result, and finally interpret and use the results. It's the traditional process in any learning analytic or data mining problem. Business analytic. This is also a new term useful today, you know? It's data analytic and business analytic are very related, business analytics with data analytics. They use analytic method, manually, automatically, relationship from data, include asset, reporting, analysis, supervised software to drive business or not business, performance, and decision making. A business analytics can integrate from information and knowledge discovery, decision support, and intelligence system, visualization also. The most new term is big data. No? Big data is the term for a collection of data sets from large, complex, that is become difficult to process. This is from hand database management tools or traditional data processing due to the complexity of the huge amount of data. For example, we will see later, speak a little about MOOC, no? A lot of information. Big data have three dimensions, not three, currently I believe five, six, seven, it's increasing the name of dimension, no? Initially you have the volume, a lot of data, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, the velocity, online streaming, the velocity of the data coming to see, variety, the type of the data, number, text, meaning, image, audio, video, but they're just appearing also other more components, no? Currently, And we can see that big data try to include all this information, sensor, image, web page, database, social location, string, email, to pre-process in order to use actionable intelligence. For example, this is very relative. When I see this image, I think in multimodal learning analytics, for example, in multimodal learning analytics, you use data that come from different sources. They are not only sourced from logging, but also from voice, from video, from the student, to you can monitor the student, and you can obtain data from a different source, similar than this, in order to obtain really, really big data. Okay, and finally, data science. Data science is, the new term is also included the word generalizable. It's a generalization. This is the why I like this term, because it tries to generalize. There's a lot of related terms, a lot of people, what do you do? I do machine learning, and you, I'm in statistics, I'm learning analytics, I'm data miner, and it's the same, not the same, a lot of conference, and what conference in the paper, to this conference, to other conference, it's the same, not the same. So this new term try to generalize, try to integrate. We work all in the same, we work all with data, in this case with educational data. So I like this term because it's integrate of the term, no? It's a generalizable extraction of knowledge from data. So it the same idea that the other do. In fact, as a scientists in USA, a lot of enterprise try to find data scientists. They call it unicorns because there are few, and there are a lot of mastering data science in order to try new data scientists, because a lot of enterprise looking for people in this area, in data science. Data science, the definition is the ability to find, interpret, reject, source, manage large amount of data. So it includes also big data, you see? It includes all the terms, interpret big data sources, merge data flows together, and ensure consistency, create visualization. This also includes the statistics, includes machine learning, it includes all. Building mathematical models, also again, mathematical model is a statistic also. Using data, present, communicate the data, present and communicate the data in sign finding. This is also in learning analytics. The presentation is very important in learning analytics, the presentation and the design. So especially the scientific in your team, in their team, and not expert audience. So if we see this figure, data science include the statistics, math, mathematical, scientific method, data engineering, domain expert, hacker, visualization, advanced computing. It tried to include all the previous area in one single term. Okay, this is the where we start from, the related term. So we can now start speaking about the specific term, educational data science. Okay, educational data science, what is? Educational is a multidisciplinary domain and related communities. We will see that there are several related communities and not only the two bigger that we know. In the definition, it's very related than other. This educational data science supply data science not only with data that only works, not only not that only work with data that are from educational environment. Setting for solving educational problems. Okay, it's a data science, but apply it only with data that come from educational to resolve educational problems. So it's multidisciplinary, of course, and there are several related communities. In fact, some of the origins communities, they are older, but they are related with the two most important of the two that there these two. We know this, you know. For example, so she say, what is educational design? Educational designing or learning analytics. This is the two more related areas. Learning analytics, we will speed up this both because they are the bigger, no? Learning analytics and educational designing. But There are also other communities. For example, we have academic or institutional analytic. We have also systematic or structural improvement. We have also learner, analytic and personalization, recommendation. In fact, this area with the corresponding conference and society worked years ago using educational data, but they don't speak about data mining and they don't speak, but they working in recommendation system, personalization, in, for example, in pedagogy, education, about how to improve instruction. So they are working about the same, but they don't know that all together are in the same area, in educational data science. Okay, we define some of them. We start, for example, with the not so well known. For example, the first, learner, analytic, and personalization, and also educational recommender system. This is an area is growing a lot, but with the conference related with recommender system. Recommender system, what is applied to educational is educational recommender system, is personalization. It's, for example, from the Olga Santo in Boticario working in this area, published some issues about this. It's increasing, and they publish in other type of conference. They publish in recommender system conference. In this area, they work at the macro or learning level in order to explore how difference about learning affect the persistence, how overall college success can be increased using adaptation, personalization, recommendation techniques. There is a lot of theory about this, how to apply this to educational system. The second, systematic or instructional improvement. They are working a lot of educational pedagogy years ago in this, in how to improve educational instruction and data-driven making in education, data-driven decision-making. So years ago, there are a lot of people working in this. And if we apply data-driven decision-making in education, we have to, you know. Is the use of data, for example, from test-based system and state longitudinal data, primarily to evaluate, not learning, primarily to evaluate the teaching method in order to take decision to how to improve the teaching method. Okay. The original presentation was this. This is the educational data mining. This is the area in which I have worked when I finished my thesis. So, this is the, for me, the center 10, but it's very related with the other. No? What is educational data mining? The educational data mining was the application of data mining techniques. In fact, it's the knowledge discovery process. You will see now the data mining process applying to a specific educational data. The difference when we apply to educational, we have to start from a hypothesis formulation. We have an agreement, but we have to put a, for example, we have in a class and we want to see if I use a presentation of if I use videos with two control, they will improve better the student in the class when I use a slide or when I use video. So you have to start from a formulation hypothesis. You have the umbrella and you impart the class and you obtain ready data. You have to process the data in order to have the data to can be used for the specific data mining tool software that you will use. In order to assign, this is the training testing, you obtain the model patterns that you have to interpret and evaluate in order to see that you can obtain something or not, because sometimes you obtain data, you don't obtain nothing. Or you come to affect your initial hypothesis. So sometimes you come to start again. This is a cycle and refinement in order to try to find the read that you want to test or to share. Okay. EDM is a multidisciplinary domain. In fact, it is an intersection of three main domains: computer science, education, and statistics. In this specific, we can to join, for example, when we join computer science with education, It appeared computer-based education. There are software of computer-based education. We joined computer science with statistics. It appeared data mining machine learning. When we joined educational with statistics, it had therapy and analytics. But learning analytics, I put more in the middle. We see where I put learning analytics. This is not only in here because it's more in the center. The data mining is an intersection of the three. But from a point of view, it's not is in this side only for educational validity. It also uses educational data mining method. So it's in this, but a little more oriented in this point. We'll see later the definition, but we see. There are two very, very closed related areas. The two more related areas with this are this, learning analytics and academic decisional analytics. Learning analytics, the definition is the measurement, collection, analysis, reporting about data, about learning, context, or purpose on the study of missing learning and the environment in which occurs. For me, the main difference between this and this, they are different. Yes, you try to see what are the specific difference. For example, Josie Emmer and Ryan Bakker try to define what are the really different between, but I don't want to see difference. They are the same, but the difference is who is the person, who is the stakeholder who use it, and to the viewpoint the difference. For example, educational data mining normally is more oriented in the algorithms because the final user normally is used for data miner, computer science expert. So the most important part for the computer science side was the algorithm, the performance, the accuracy. So they view all the process was centered in the data mining process. Okay, in this. Educational data mining, the most important of all the process is this. Okay. On the other side, learning analytics is more oriented in the data and the application in the other two sides. That for me are also very, very important, of course. So the preprocessing the data to use, a lot of time we will see that a lot of time we are working in preprocessing data. It's very important. If you don't have really good data, you cannot say nothing. You can try to optimize the algorithm, but if the data they don't show you, instead you optimize the parameter, you don't find nothing. And also, it's a lot of important, it's very, very important, the application, the interpretation. You don't apply the results in educational, and the result can be applied and obtain the result. The model can be very good, but it's not applicable. So, in learning analytics, is more oriented in this and in this, and in educational data mining in this, but all work in the same. So it's the same, but it depends, like the similar dog, but with different color. Because they are all, you see, they are very, very, very related. Okay, this is another term, very, very related. Academic or institutional analytic. This is more related, for example, from the business intelligence domain applied to institutional data in order to improve the university as a business, as an enterprise, to optimize the teacher. In this case, the data are from the teacher, the data are from the department, the data are from the university. What are the best university, what master of degree have to be in part in the future. This is less working in this, but in the future, I see that this is a very good area that will increase it because government will see the money here to decide. No? I also like this slide, this graphic view. Because we can see a comparison between the two most related areas. We see the evolution of EDM publication versus learning analytic publication by years, from 2004 on 2014. And the fact is the first year educational data mining has more published paper, but between 2012 and 2013, it changed, you see? Changed, and learning analytics have more reference. You will see from this year. Why? We can explain this if we see the evolution of the communities and the conference. So, this is a little brief summary of the evolution of the areas. No? For example, the first papers that I have to find about educational domain, in fact, was about prediction. The first paper I find in the 1990s, from 1981-1983, was paper that applied a neural network to predict student performance.
Yes, years ago.
But there are some paper and they stop the publication. In some years they stop. And in 2000 year, it start some specific workshop about educational data mining in a conference about intelligent tutoring system and artificial intelligence in education. There are four, five, several workshops until 2005. But indeed. And they speak now about, in this workshop, it appeared the first time, the third educational data mining. It appeared in this workshop. I finished my thesis in 2003. In the middle, I finished my thesis. I have working in applying genetic programming, genetic algorithm, to improve intelligent tutoring system, adaptive hypermedia. I have mixed. I mix genetic algorithm. This is one of the soft computing in that mining. With adaptive hypermedia, I mean, I have to mix in my thesis. And why I do this? I only like to explain this because I have two directors. I have two different directors that they allow me to do this. Because one was an educational. An educational in years ago, he worked in adaptive hypermedia, similar to Sibulowski, Paul Debra, adaptive hypermedia. Was the chain years ago, so. And the other director is a data miner that working in genetic algorithm, so computing. And they say, no, I only work in this. And the other say, I only work, and I try to join. And he say, how to join these two very, very different. And I applied genetic algorithm to discover rules that can provide me information about how to improve the adaptation in adaptive hypermedia. So when I finished my thesis, I published one of the reviews in the term, educational data mining, because I see the progression of the area. And in 2008, in 2005, I published the data mining learning book. This is the first book published in the area that the title was in this year, data mining, because I use data mining. In e-learning was the third. Years ago, in 2008, was the first educational data mining conference in Montreal. So many people prefer the term educational data mining, educational data mining. And in 2010, we published the handbook. This is a really, really handbook. The book, you know, in Spanish, it's very good, it's very big. The handbook of EDM was co-edited together with Ryan Baker, the previous president of EDM. Nicola Pechinski is the current president of EDM conference. Sebastian Ventura is my director, one of my director of the thesis, my chief, current chief. And I, Cristóbal Romero, who is the handbook in 2010. And 2011, the first LA conference. This year, we see this, and we now can explain that from here it increased a lot. The progression of LA conference from the conference is the first conference, though, the number of recent papers that use the new term, learning analytical knowledge, is due to the first conference. And also, this is a SNOLA community. EDN have the EDN community, and lab conference have the SNOLA community. It's a very active community. I like about also how work LARC and SNOLA. In fact, you are here in a LASI summer. It's very, very active, and they the result, what is? More people use the new term, more people are more active, and you are here now speak about learning analytic. So you will use the term. So. And I have also detected another new conference, the little one is also very related, the Learning at Scale Conference. Learning at Scale Conference started 2014. And this year, for example, in Edinburgh, was the both LARC and LASI was collocated in Edinburgh, both conference. I request to the next year, to CM, Reinbacher, to put the three conference together. In the end, LARC, of course, the three conference. You know that I don't have to go each year to three different conference. Why not? The three together. You don't have to go to one conference, to another, and another, to different. Okay, but they see that in the future maybe, but currently, okay. So next year you will have to go to, well, it's a lab will be in Vancouver, learning and scale, I don't know, and EDN, I don't know, EDN was this weekend in New Caroline, this week. Okay, let's continue. The process and actor. Okay, this is the life cycle of educational data science. In this, we can see that on one side, we see the academic authorities, the professor, and on the other side, we have the students. Okay? Professor and academic authority as in charge of the design, will, maintain the learning environment. In the other side, students interact with the learning environment. So, we can obtain a lot of data from this learning environment about not only about use interaction, but also information about the courses, academic data about the student, previous information about the student data, and all the information that we can obtain from a student. For example, in the future, I imagine multimodal learning analytics. I imagine in the future, the smart classroom in which this class will be real monitored, webcam, with audio, in which one only professor can really manage a very, very big class. You have a more or less big class, in the class start speaking, you can say, hey, the last student, you are sleeping. But is the class very, very, very big? You can see in the middle of the class, imagine a very big class. One single professor, not can interact, but also the problem can also use the information from the student in class. What the student are sitting in the first side, in the last, what the student are all the time more interested, see to the slide, what student is request. You can obtain all the data in real time using multimodal. So you get all the information, but also by hand. So for example, the attendance, the exam, all the information will be used. When we will have all this information, we apply educational data science, also big data. And using the information, we can obtain several objectives. For example, in this side, we can obtain information about how to provide new knowledge, or useful information from the viewpoint of professor or from the viewpoint of academic authority. And in this side, from the student, we can also obtain useful information directly useful from the student. For example, to make recommendations. What is the next course you can do? What is the next book you can read? What is the next link you can go? So make recommendation directly to the student can be also provided by professionals. Okay, so there is a several, there are those good objects. This good depend of the scale holder of the finalist. For example, if the goals from the point of view of student or the student perspective. Now some example. For example, which activity or which resource and task could improve the academic performance of students, or which activity are the most suited to give a student knowledge or in his profile, or which path or route a student must travel to obtain a specific resource. Of course, based on previous knowledge or comparing the past by other students similar to your profile. More or this is more personalization, recommendation, adaptation. From the professor perspective, there are a lot. Why there are a lot? No, it's because in the past the own research were in this, so they are more a lot of more work in this. But this is not because it's not so important, but they are more because the own teacher was the data mining expert, they are the researchers. So there are a lot of work. For example, in quantify the activity of learning, to organize the content of given course. This is also related with adaptation, to improve or review the structure of course, the same, to evaluate the activity performance in a course, performance, motivation, to monitor activity, to find the most common error, to set the level of activity, to personalize and adapt the content of a course, to classify student or group the student from the features, to find behavioral pattern in student, more and more. And for example, there is other perspective. There are a lot of problems. Each researcher can put a new problem in this line. This is some example. And for example, from institutional perspective, from the point of view of the institutional, academic viewpoint. For example, we can try to improve the efficiency of the website of the university, for example, website. The university to adapt, for example, the user behavior in order to design the optimal server, the network traffic distribution, or also to organize the institutional resources. For example, thinking in automatically time-tabling, and assigning classroom, teacher, the schedule automatically, yeah, from using information from previous years. And also planning acquisition. For example, to apply curriculum money, improve academic offer, demand-oriented program. What will the more demand program in the future? And also to recommend curriculum meaning. For example, we can recommend to a student what is the travel or the course that they have to follow and the next master that he have to do. Also, for example, to group student according to objective capacity. Okay, let's change. Now we will speak to the most important. For me, the most important part is the data. More than the techniques. Okay, the data is more important. Why the data is so important? In educational environment, there is a lot of type of environment. There are traditional educational and computer-based education. In traditional educational, we have primary educational, infant, special educational, secondary, alternative, higher educational. But in computer-based educational, we have learning management system, so for example, Moodle, IDEAS, intelligent tutoring system, test and quiz systems, adaptive and intelligent hypermedia systems, learning audio repository, wiki, forum, game, request, environment, and now appear a big one, MOOC, is the new fashion there, for example, is growing, but in the future can appear more type of ubiquitous is here, see, ubiquitous, environment. Okay. What is the characteristics of the data that come from educational? The information first, come from different sources of data. Normally, come from different. We will have to integrate. Normally, they come from nothing. They come from several. There are a lot of incomplete and lots of data because not all the students carry out all the activity. Not all the students attend to all the classes. So all the students coming to the learning model, learning management system. Now all the students do the exam. Now all the students do a specific test. Now all the students. So we have a lot of information. So the when you have the data, you have a lot of noise, incomplete, loose, or data. No? You will have to work with this type of data, or delay this student, or record the information, or something to do. The third, user student are clearly identified. Normally, in the learning management system, and in class, you have specifically identified. We only have to anonymize. Later, we'll speak about anonymization later. But this is not a problem. In other problem, in the web, in some other problem, you have the problem to identify really the user, but here no, don't have this problem. There is a great number of favorite instance and attributes that require tasks of filtering or selecting the most important. You will have problem not only of big data, you can have a lot of instance, you have a MOOC, you have thousands and thousands of students, but you have also a multidimensional problem because you can also have a lot of attributes. It's only grow not only in the row but the column also. A lot of attributes. And if you have a lot of attributes, information of the class, information, attribute about the class, attribute about the practice, attribute about the attendance, attribute of all that you want. There is a problem with the size, it's very big, and the technique. We have to lose, no? You lose because you need to focus and to select the most important attribute for to solve your problem. Okay? Another specific characteristic. Educational data have different level of granularity. We'll see. We can work a low level granularity with log, with click, or we can work a high level with less data, with summarization information about the student. At what level? Activity level, course level, what do you want? Okay? You have to select what level you will want. And also, there are some transformations, such as normalization, and also discretization, that are useful in order to improve the comprehensibility of the training model. Okay. About the training usage, sometimes depends the techniques that you use. Sometimes it depends on the type of data that you use. For example, if you have relational data with database, relational databases, you have to use relational data mining. If you have transactional data, you can apply the classic classification, clustering, association, role mining. We will work with this type of data in the workshop. With that specific type, a high level, summarization file, transactional, a high level. For example, if we work with temporal sequencing and time series data with log, you can use sequential data mining. If you have tech data, you have to use tech mining. If you have multimedia data, it's now also a lot of people working with multimedia data, about video, voice, so you have to use multimedia data mining. Or if you work in traditional World Wide Web, you work with what content, what structure, or what say. This is in general. Okay, and the tasks. There are two different type of tasks when you have to resolve a problem in educational design. There are general, more general educational learning tasks, specific. The general are low-level tasks. The low-level tasks are similar to the machine learning and the data mining. But the knowledge we want to discover is stuck on educational data. Okay? There are low-level tasks, more classification, association. It's smaller block. We have smaller block. And there are all higher block, the high-level tasks. The high-level tasks, they are more specific in educational data mining, in which we try to resolve a real problem. Now we want to resolve an educational problem that it involves to resolve several of these low-level tasks. okay, in order to solve a problem, you have to do, for example, field preprocessing, then clustering, and then classification. And the problem was to predict the use of some tasks, we predict the, or not the, the finger map. You use the low-level task in order to use the higher level. What does the low-level task? The low-level tasks are the traditional machine learning algorithms. For example, predictive tasks are there two tasks, predictive and descriptive tasks in data mining machine learning. The descriptive tasks are supervised, in which you have the information about the outputs. You know a priori the information about the classic payload. The samples are classification, the class is categorical, or regression when the output, the class is numerical. And over at the descriptive task, the descriptive task unsupervised. The information about the output, the class is not known a priori, and some example association rules and clustering. We will see a sample of this task in the workshop with you. And high level tasks. There are some examples of high level tasks of problems that can be solved in educational domain. That I try to put here is a histogram about the numbers of numbers of papers in each area. No? The number of reference of papers in each one of these categories. That is all the I don't remember the year 2050 maybe. So you can add a lot more problem of tasks. In fact, you can try to resolve a new problem. For example, there, the first column is the analysis and visualization. Analysis from the point of view of statistics, no? Or from a more point of view of initial learning analytic and visualization, probably general information about the data, no? The second, providing feedback to the instructor. This is the second one, for example, providing feedback to the instructor, recommendation to the student, recommendation to the students, predicting student performance. But the number, you don't have important to the number because they change. They is all reference, they have changed a lot. In order to see a sample or application, the student modeling, detecting behaviors, for example, detecting back or rate behaviors, gaming, some example when the student do a normal behavior, also grouping student, social network analysis, for example, this is social network analysis, currently this is not, is wow, there's a lot of work currently, social network analysis has increased a lot in the last year. So social network analysis is a lot of work. For example, also developing automatically concept map, automatically planning and scheduling, and also, for example, constructing causeway. Constructing causeway years ago, when I started to work in adaptive hypermedia, there was a lot of people working in tool for authoring software. And there is a line of research that automatically constructing a causeway, that the matching construct automatically along the causes. I want a cause, in Java, and they find the resources from internet, from learning all your repository, and recommend you the course, the structure automatically, in only that you only have to accept. So the course is written automatically by the machine. So there are this type of, there are a lot of more curriculum means, there are a lot of, okay. Publication about the area, okay. There are several books. For example, this is the Data Mining Learning book. This is the first book that I published. The second book is the handbook. This is the handbook. And it appear some new book. For example, Educational Data Mining Application on Trend is published by Alejandro Peña Ayala. This is this book. And also, for example, this learning analytics from the same practice. Currently, there are several other that mix learning analytics with the educational learning in the world. For example, Osmat Saini is now publishing one book with the TED together, learning analytics, educational learning. It will be published in this month. Okay, but I get that there will be more book about this term. That they mix the tutor learning analytics with the future will be mixed. Okay, survey and review. Wow, survey and review, they are a lot. I have published three reviews. The first was, this is my first review that was published in a presentation application in 2007. Two years later, Ryan Baca and Paulina Alce in the Journal of Educational Tamil published the State of R, 2009. Later, this a little bigger in session system published in 2010. This is a very good. I like this because in this survey, Karen Cator and other researchers from USA, it meets the term and has a teaching and learning through educational domain learning analytics, but. It's a report requested by the USA Office of Education Technology in 2012. They detect that this area is growing and they want to know what is this. So from this year, in USA there are a lot of interest from the administrative, there are a lot of budget, there are a lot of projects about this. Okay. In 2013, I published another. In this survey, that I need education, is a survey of surveys, because there are so many hundred surveys that it was impossible to review all the publishes in the area. So I published a survey of surveys about surveys. In fact, these slides are a summary of this. This paper. Okay, it's a try to summarize. Our conference about the area. The first, for example, is International Conference of Educational Data Mining. It started in 2018 in Montreal, Cordoba, Pittsburgh, Dover, and currently this week in North Carolina. Okay, Learning Analytics and Knowledge. It started in 11th. And this year was in Edinburgh together with Learning at the Scale. Okay, was together in 16 this year in Edinburgh. Oh, warning. There is a fake conference. Warning, we have detected yet a conference with the same title. See the title, International Conference on Educational Data Mining. But if you see the paper, the proceeding, the abstract, you can see educational domain paper. They are general about computer science general or electricity or I don't know, but I say what. From 100 papers, only one or two have something speaking about a little data mining. I say, what? But this is a worry because some new researchers that see this conference and say, okay, this is the good conference, and they send the paper to this conference that is not the official educational data mining conference with the Society of Educational Data Mining, okay? So warning with this conference. And also there are related conferences that are organized that also publish paper about this, organize workshop about the EDA and learning analytics, for example, artificial intelligence educational conference, intelligent system, and also knowledge discovery data mining, user modeling that touch personal session, European conference technology enhanced learning. They are also very related. Okay, resources, free available resources in the area. There are several societies. The one is Educational Data Mining Society. This is the web page in which you have the journal of Educational Data Mining, free available. You have OCD, you have some resources, okay? You can do a lot of information on this page. Also, you have the Society for Learning Analytics SNOLA. This is the web page in which you have also information, okay, and also about the journal. There is also a EEE task force on a specific educational training. We have detected. Years ago, I remember Ryan and all the American people are talking, what is this? Who person have created this? And nobody knows the person. It's an Australian people. He's from Australia. The person, I don't remember the name. He has, I think, 7 or 8 editor of 5 or 8 international journal with bad factor. It's a very big researcher in the community of computer science in general. And they create this task force. The task force is here in the task force, right? They have only organized a special session in a conference, and they haven't promoted more the task force, but it is it. Okay, more. There are several MOOC specifically oriented to this. For example, in EDX, Ryan Bakker, part of the Big Data and Educational MOOC. Okay. About the title is it's very it's not real because it's more data mining educational or learning analytics. The title Big Data, you put the title in order to have the fashion term Big Data. But really, if you the course is not closed, but you have seen the courses in general EDM. Another good MOOC is, I think that is your Siemens, is Data Analytics and Learning MOOC. The teacher was Jörg Siemens. More. Other sources, for example, this is the data shop, pre-available data, but it's only from Intelligent Tutoring System. It's from Carnegie Mellon. The problem, they are free, but they are specific about the specific software that they use in USA, a lot of Key 12 in class for intelligent tutoring courses about math, about learning English. So they are very specific data. They are free, but the problem is they are specific. This is a very good data set. It is public in the benchmark in UC. The student performance data set, for example, this is the first data set free available in UC that I have detected in all educational. Okay. Also, in KDD conference, the last challenger, past year, is about predicting dropout in MOOC. Was available all the data. Okay, there was a competition from the dropout. There was available. Also, for example, Linked Education. Linked Education is a European project about linked data. Linked data, but it also have information or more about the all the publisher, all the paper publishing, all the conference, all the journal. They have all the information that you can use, and also they have linked data in. FDF file, and you have you can see what author what the hot topics, what the hot author, okay, in the conference, the journal. Software to do data mining or learning analytics. There are a lot of software. There are some examples. For example, this is similar than what you mobile phone. Android is Apple is. It's the same. Some people like Wicca, right? For example, I use Java years ago, and I like Wicca. It's also it's open source, it's in Java, it's free, it's a user interface, okay? There are other people that like RapidMiner, for example. Other people like, I prefer RapidMiner, or Kamine. And also, for example, this R is a programming language that is increasing a lot on Python. For example, there is a lot of people working to R. it's it also very, very good. There are another workshop about that in LASI. Okay. There are specific someone about educational design?
Yes, a lot.
What is the problem? Oh, why don't try to do log or to request one of these specific software? The problem is that the specific software is to resolve the specific problem, and the work is that it only works with the specific data or the specific tool. For example, I use EP rules. EP rules only work with data that come from AHA, Adaptive Hypermedia from Technical University of Leuven. It's not generic, it only work with this. So there is a problem about there are a lot of tools, but they are not free available, most of them, and they are specific to resolve. Only work with some specific to resolve the problem. But for example, a specific software for use with Moodle data. There are some free and there are a little more generalists. So I recommend some of them. For example, this is a comparison about the tool. They are free or not free. They are integrated into to Moodle, the language they use. They have visualization. They have pre-processing technique. They have supervising technique. All supervising. They have classification. They have association or not. And for example, this is a very good tool. Gizmo is developed by Riccardo Massa from Italy. This small tool is free, and you cannot time from, you can install your Moodle. The problem is that you have to be administration or to add a new. But you can obtain information, visualization about all the activity of the process. Okay? There are, for example, social network tools, also for using log in Moodle, IntelliJ Boa, Smart Class, Engage Analytics, Graph Analytics. So there are several tools that you can this is all the presentation. It's a very big presentation. I have more and more flyer, but I have to do it then I'm in order to fix and thank you. And
Yeah, it's right.
If you have any questions, we can speak later in the coffee break or the lunch. Or... Okay.
Thank you.